On the 23rd of August, the Chandrayaan-3 mission from India achieved a successful landing at the moon's south pole. This milestone made India the fourth nation to put a vehicle on the moon and the first one ever to accomplish this feat at the lunar south pole. Completing a controlled descent that lasted 19 minutes, the spacecraft settled on the moon at 8:32 a.m. Eastern Time, eliciting ecstatic reactions from a well-deserving team of Indian specialists monitoring the mission. In this episode, let's dive in more in depth of how India accomplished this mission, what comes next to the moon exploration, and much more. You are watching Adventures in Space. Following a successful launch, the lander's orbit was incrementally elevated before executing a propulsion maneuver on July 31st to direct it towards the moon. For the subsequent 5 days, the lander, dubbed Vikram, journeyed through outer space, entering the moon's orbit on the 5th of the August. ISRO then released imagery indicating that the spacecraft had successfully arrived at its target location, in anticipation of an expected landing on August 23rd. Once in lunar orbit, Vikram used its propulsion system for additional engine burns to stabilize its path in a circular orbit approximately 60 miles, around 100 kilometers, above the moon's surface. A week before the scheduled landing attempt, specifically on August 17th, Vikram detached from the propulsion module after carrying out a sequence of maneuvers aimed at the moon, initiating the final stage of its mission, which was to land on the moon. The planned landing area for the rover measured 4 by 2.5 kilometers. Scientists and engineers at ISRO segmented this zone into 3,900 uniform smaller areas, each scrutinized for landing safety. This data served as an onboard reference for the lander. The head of ISRO's Space Application Center noted that if the lander were positioned over the predefined landing region, its onboard computer would autonomously choose the safest segment for landing. If located elsewhere, the lander would carry out an independent landing, relying on its own imaging to identify risks rather than using the preloaded data. In the concluding phase of its descent, the rover descended to an altitude of about 150 meters above the lunar surface, hovering momentarily to evaluate potential landing hazards. Deeming the area directly below it to be risky, the lander opted for a safer neighboring spot to make its landing. This entire process of final descent and gentle touchdown was recorded and later released by ISRO's Mission Operations Complex. After the triumphant landing, the Prime Minister of India announced the nation's successful arrival on the moon. The lander successfully made contact with the lunar surface at a latitude of 69.37 degrees south and a longitude of 32.35 degrees east, situated in a fairly level terrain bordered by craters. This represented the highest latitude at which any spacecraft has ever softly landed on the moon. The European Space Agency's S-Track Deep Space Tracking Station in Australia assisted the descent by offering supplementary tracking capabilities, serving as a backup to ISRO's own ground facilities. Additionally, the lander linked up with an orbiter from a prior mission that has been orbiting the moon since 2019, a connection that will be pivotal for communications with Earth for the mission's remaining duration. After landing, the primary Vikram lander waited several hours for the dust stirred up by its descent to clear before deploying its Pragyan rover, thereby initiating India's inaugural exploration of the moon. Ground teams from ISRO confirmed that both the lander and rover were functioning as expected. The mission's first two key goals had been met: safely landing the Vikram lander and demonstrating the Pragyan rover's capabilities on the lunar terrain. The third aim, which was the principal reason for targeting the moon's south pole, is to analyze local materials. The Vikram lander comes equipped with instruments like a thermal sensor to assess temperature levels and the soil's heat retention capacity. Additionally, it has a seismometer for detecting lunar seismic activity and a Langmuir probe to measure near-surface plasma density. Because the moon lacks an atmosphere, its soil can maintain a minor electrical charge that accumulates plasma, something not easily observed elsewhere. The Pragyan rover, equipped with 6 wheels, features a miniaturized X-ray spectrometer to closely examine the moon's soil and a laser-based spectroscope to analyze the basic elements in the lunar soil and rocks. This scientific endeavor is time-sensitive, lasting only for a lunar day, equivalent to 14 Earth days, until the South Pole moves out of sunlight, causing freezing conditions that will incapacitate both the lander and rover. The most extended phase of the mission actually commenced before the launch of Chandrayaan-3. The Chandrayaan-2 orbiter has been quietly orbiting the moon, photographing the site and using its suite of tools for various tasks, such as topographic mapping and searching for water molecules. This orbiter serves as a quiet testament to ISRO's trials and tribulations in finally achieving a successful landing with their third attempt. Recent efforts by other entities, like iSpace's Hakuto-R and Russia's Luna 25, have been unsuccessful. The only countries to have successfully completed this challenging task are the United States, the former USSR, China, and now India. ISRO had previously lost their Chandrayaan-2 mission when its Vikram lander failed during the descent, due to a software glitch that affected the braking systems at crucial altitudes. This issue was addressed in the Chandrayaan-3 lander. The key to India's successful landing, unlike the failures by iSpace and Russia, was the lessons learned from their earlier mistake. The analysis of the Chandrayaan-2 lander revealed that one engine was marginally stronger than the rest, leading to computational errors. This was rectified. Additionally, discrepancies were found between the main engine's throttle and what the fuel management system believed it should be, necessitating further corrections. ISRO completed their comprehensive review in November 2019, meticulously scrutinizing each detail to ensure a successful landing for Chandrayaan-3. Unlike Luna 25, the Chandrayaan-3 mission chose a month-long pathway to conserve fuel and didn't hasten the landing process. Moreover, the data and insights gained can now contribute to NASA's Artemis missions, making this not just a victory for India, but a global achievement. The ISRO team exhibited both diligence and intelligence in securing this success and truly merits commendation. In recent years, there's been a growing fascination globally with reaching the moon, specifically its South Pole area. This zone is characterized by crater edges that receive almost perpetual sunlight, making it a highly coveted region for exploration. Its cold traps, areas that never see sunlight, are particularly important as they might hold water and ice, sourced from comets, meteorites, or solar wind interactions. Scientific tests and sample analyses have validated the existence of ice in these shaded zones. Looking ahead, a handful of countries and private organizations are likely to join the quest to investigate the moon's south pole. Japan is gearing up to initiate its Smart Lander for Investigating Moon, SLIM, mission, while firms like Intuitive Machines and Astrobotic have lunar ventures in the pipeline, as part of NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services, CLPS, initiative. India's triumphant landing in the moon's south pole region is a remarkable milestone, following a journey that spanned over a month. The lander descended and made contact with the lunar surface in excellent condition. In the upcoming days, the focus will shift to scientific activities, as India is set to activate its rover and carry out additional experiments. The unfolding developments of this mission and their influence on the aerospace sector remain to be seen. Thank you very much for watching. As you can see, the modern 21st century space race is up and running already, and will only become bigger over time. So, to never miss an update, please subscribe to our channel to stay tuned and up to date on all the aerospace industry news. If you like this video, you have two in front of you right now. As always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you in the next one.